It is one of the grandest ironies of this political year is that a giant real estate developer in New York is currently living rent-free in President Obama's head.
Why don't you mention Donald Trump by name?
You know, he seems to do a good job mentioning his own name. I continue to believe Mr. Trump will not be president.
This man has done such a bad job. He has set us back so far. And for him to say that actually is a great compliment, if you want to know the truth.
He is not somebody who can be considered as equipped to deal with the problems of this office.
With respect to the Republican process and Mr. Trump, I think foreign observers are troubled by some of the rhetoric that's been taking place.
This is not entertainment. This is not a reality show. This is a contest for the presidency of the United States. I have no thoughts on Mr. Trump's tweets. As a general rule, I don't pay attention to Mr. Trump's tweets. And I think that will be true, I think, for the next 6 months. So you can just file that one.
You know, it sounds funny, or the tweets are provocative.
Including politicians who tweet.
In fact, that's the real amnesty. Pretending we can deport 11 million people or build a wall, it's not going to work. It's not good for this country. It's a fantasy.
There's no magic to the phrase radical Islam. And the reason I am careful about how I describe this threat has nothing to do with political correctness.
He has a long record that needs to be examined.
I'm not prepared to concede the notion that some of the rhetoric that's been popping up is populist.
Mr. Trump embodies global elites and has taken full advantage of it. He's hardly a spokesperson for a legitimate spokesperson for a populist surge from working class people.
That's nativism or xenophobia.
I think there is a xenophobia and anti-immigrant sentiment that's flashing up.
Sorry. This is one of the prerogatives of when you're at the end of your term, you just kind of, you go on these occasional rants.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okie doke.
You're lucky I didn't run last time when Romney ran, because you would have been a one-term president.
Make America great again. The subtext for that is somehow that a bunch of foreigners and funny-looking people are coming in here and changing the basic character of the nation.
You know, our whole theme is make America great again, and that's what the whole deal is. We're going to make America great again.